There was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth and fifth, the minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be informed about those who sleep in beds, so that you not grieve like the rest of mankind, who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring Jesus those who have fallen asleep in bed. According to God's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord.
Before I called him, I had done what I had to do, and the Arabas had to go.
very accommodating from a distance. We, the junior ones, we always look up to him.
David played and then please.
Commander Mike Quezon was once our CSO. When he was a CSO, in fact, he made a remarkable mark. In fact, he practically chased away criminals from the West. We really miss him. But, as we used to say, we cannot go somewhere. May so rest in perfect peace.
I'm sorry, I titled this brief exhortation, Prepare for Your Own Death. Prepare for your own death. Bible says in Hebrews chapter 9 verse 17, it says, just as man is destined to die once, and after that to face judgment. That is, every one of us, it has been appointed that we will die once. And after that, there's going to be judgment.
Her beauty and the moonlight, oh love through you. She tied you to her kitchen chair. She broke your throne and she cut your hair. And from your lips, she drew the
first record.
First record.
Record. Record. Record. Record. Now what? Go.
Thank you. Christ, that no longer has dominion. So we beseech thee, give rest to thy servants and thy sanctuary, and Abraham's bosom. Grant rest to those who from Adam until now have acknowledged the purity, to our fathers and brothers, our kinsmen and friends, to all men and women who have lived by faith, and passed on their road to thee by a thousand ways, in all conditions, and make them worthy of the heavenly kingdom. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, born without end. Amen. Today, Psalm 90 in alternate order. Psalm 90 in alternate order. Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations.
Before the mountains and the fall, when you brought out the whole world, the prophet and the prophet, you
are the Lord. Return people back to dust, saying, return to dust, you mortals. Yet you sweep people away in the sleep of death. They are like the new grass of the morning. We are consumed by your anger and terrified by your indignation.
We are set up in the iniquities before you, as our secrets in the light of your presence.
All our days pass away under your wrath. We finish our years with one.
Our days become successive years of iniquity. If our strength and guilt, then the rest of men are the drop of the sorrow. For they will be passed and fly in the blood of
you. Evenly we knew the power of your anger. Your wrath is as great as the fear that is due of you.
Teach us to number our days, that we may gain and have our wisdom.
Relent, Lord. How long will it be? Have compassion on your servants. Make us glad for as many days as you have afflicted us, for as many years as we have seen trouble.
We are praying for your servants, for the sign of their children.
Together,
we pray for the Lord our God, Christ for us, to establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, Lord Jesus.
We will cease to sing the next hymn, when peace are to live on, and send us
thank you.
brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be informed about those who sleep in beds, so that you not grieve like the rest of mankind, who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him. According to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet call of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these kind words. This is the word of the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we look forward to appreciate you for today and for our great practice. We thank you for the life of your Son, Christ, as we call it. Thank you for giving him to us for 20 years. Thank you for all the things that you did when he was here and blessed you. And we ask God that those things that he did that did not please him, we will learn from it and will avoid it. We thank you for his wife, Diana. We bless you, Lord, for his children and grandchildren. For all this, Lord, we say in your name we praise you forever and ever. As we gather here this evening, to remind ourselves of his life, and also remind ourselves that one day is to be our God. So as we read in his Son a few minutes ago, teach us, Lord, to know our days, so that we can apply our hearts unto this world. You have given us Jesus Christ. May we offer him our life. May we accept him as the Lord of our life. May we walk in his grace. May we remain under his umbrella throughout our stay here on earth. Whatever will take us away from under his umbrella, may not be our portion. Thank you for all those who are here this evening to honor your Son. We lay all the honor in the mighty name of Jesus. So as we continue this service of song, please be present amongst us. And sanctify all of your ability to do it. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. We continue as we sing the next name by faith we serve to you. Of the seven, I feel it's hard to do.
Now we know that if the earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven, not built by human hands. Meanwhile, we grow, longing to be clothed with our heavenly dwellings. We will not be found naked. For while we are in this tent, we grow and are burdened because we do not wish to be unclothed, but to be clothed with our heavenly dwelling, so that what is mortal may be swallowed up by life. Now it is God who has made us for this very purpose and has given us the Spirit as a deposit, guaranteeing what is to come. Therefore, we are always confident and know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. We will live by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I said, and would prefer to be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So we make it our goal to please Him, whether we are at home, in the body, or away from it. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that each one may receive what is due to him for the things done while in the body, whether good or bad. This is the word of the Lord.
To come and do this in honor of our Lord brother. Father, we want to pray that as we continue, you will minister to our lives in the name of Jesus. God begins, God prays, the word that we shall be listening to. Lord, we pray you will affect us positively to live the rest of our lives to fulfill your purpose on earth in the name of Jesus. According to your word that we are listening to, the Apostle Paul says that we will make it our own goal, that we will live to please the Lord. Father, we want to pray for everyone that is here today. You will give us that grace that made us to make it our goal to live to please you and bring you honor in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray that today you will endow upon us that grace and power that lives above the flesh, above sin and the world, in the name of Jesus. Whatever has been contending with the place of God in our lives, Father, we pray that today we receive power to overcome them in the name of Jesus. Lord, we want to pray for the family of your beloved whom you have called to yourself. We pray for your wife, we pray for members of the family. Today you will strengthen them afresh and you continue to stand by them in the name of Jesus. As you continue on this funeral arrangement, I pray for you, you will not be weak, you will not be tired, you will not be sick. God has started with you. The Lord God will complete what He has begun with you in the name of Jesus. During and after this funeral, there shall be no bad news unto you in the name of Jesus. All the travelers want to hand them over to the hands of the Lord. We pray for joyful messages concerning every one of them in the name of Jesus. And when they shall be done with this honor and shall be going back to their destinations, the Lord will take them home safely in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we want to pray, even especially for the wife. At a time like this, you will be our strength. You will be our consolation. You will need to uphold her with the right hand of righteousness in the name of Jesus. For all the children in your walks of life, the Lord will support you. The Lord will stand by you. He will encourage you. You will never be afraid in life in the name of Jesus Christ. And to everyone who has come today to do this honor unto our beloved brother, we want to pray for you. Come, things of honor, things of joy will attend your way in the name of Jesus. God will meet you at the point of your needs. I want to ask that by the mercy of the Lord, every one of us that is here gathered this evening will enjoy longevity, good
Jesus Christ, our Lord. At this time, we would like to give opportunity to two or three persons to say some things about departed beloved. We know we've been with him for many years. We've experienced the touch of God in his life. So it's time to allow us to say some few things to edify ourselves. The Apostle Paul says to us that to us, when any of our beloved one is called home, life is only changed, not taken away. And it says that we should not do like the unbelievers who do not have hope. So we want to listen to testimonies that will edify us to continue to forge ahead with the Lord and fulfill our purpose in the land of the living. So I'd like to just permit two or three at most. If you have testimony about him, please just raise your hand to signify, and I'll give you the opportunity to say something about him. Now we have two or three. One from the family members, and then one from his friends, and then possibly a church member. Okay, Baba says from the neighborhood where he lived. While he was with us. So the family member, just 2 minutes, and then a friend, thank you, 2 minutes, sir, and then someone from the neighborhood. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for coming today to honor my father. My name is Ikechukwu Michael Okwesa. One thing on my dad, I would say is that he wanted to make sure the name Michael continues in the family. So I'm the firstborn, and when I had my first child, and I reached out to dad to say, what name would you give our son, his grandchild? He said, Michael now. You know, there's no nothing else to say about that. So, you know, his grandson, Jaden Michael Okwesa, carries his name Michael. And obviously, you know, when I was born, he ensured that Michael was added to my name. He's a wonderful man. He was not perfect. But one thing that he instilled in us was to ensure that we just gave our best in everything that we did. That's all he asked. I remember I disappointed him when I told him that I wasn't going to be an engineer like him. And he didn't talk to me for 2 weeks. But he turned around and supported me. And the one thing that he said was, it doesn't matter what you do, just make sure that you do your best every day. And so that's something that's been instilled in my siblings, myself, my children, and we will ensure that we continue to honor him and give our best in everything that we do. So Dad, you know, we miss you, may your soul rest in peace, we love you, and God bless you. Thank you.
My name is Odidison, Captain Odidison. To talk about Omarokwesa, I don't even know where to start. It was more of to me, an elder brother to me. We first met when I moved into a current neighborhood. I was the first to move in there. And then he started building right away. And there was this rapport between us. I noticed he was very meticulous. He had this spirit of engineering in him. And we became friends. Apart from friends, our friendship grew to even brotherly love. Commodo was always there for me. We had difficult times. Those days in the neighborhood when we first moved in, we were always being attacked by rumors. and Commodore Nkwesa was always my fallback. He will come to the house, he will counsel me, he will lift up and preach, and he will tell me what actions to take from the military angle. He was able to support me, and the next time Aaron escaped, even before I called him, I had done what I had to do, and the Arabas had to go. We forever be missed on the street. We were very close. And if most people wanted Commodore, they asked me. Or if they wanted me, they asked Commodore. Many times, before I fell here, most evenings, he was a soccer enthusiast like me. And he was always stopped by my house most evenings to watch the current soccer together while he nurses maybe a bottle of beer or something. Almost every evening, if you want to come out, he was in my house. When he fell ill, it was the most touching experience I ever had. He was a very active, very jovial, very bubbly man. All of a sudden, he found himself around it. Each time I went to see him when he was here, I just couldn't handle it. I was going through my mind and eventually I stopped. Because the commander I knew then as a very active, fine, jovial officer was not the same person. We pray that wherever he is, the good Lord will take care of him in the bosom of the boat. He was extremely very friendly with my family. He was always in my place or I was in his place. And in those days, when he was more outgoing, we used to go to boat club together. And Commodore was known in the boat club, everyone. First time I went to boat club with him, I asked him, I said, are you? He said, well, he used to call me Capitan. I said, don't worry, that's how we are. But to cut it short, he was not to be very close to me. He was useful to most people too on our streets. I remember for a long time, he was the CSO of our streets, Chief Special Officer. We had challenges on our streets. We were going to him for advice. And he was always forthcoming. He was always there giving his advice, always there to counsel you, and always there for you. As for me and my family, when he fell ill for so long, it was difficult. And up to now, we still can't meet Ando. We know that in his usual way, wherever Commodore is now, he's in a safe, good place. And we pray that the goodness which he showed most of us, especially I, will always be grateful for the times we shared with Commodore. He was always very jovial and very friendly. Most evenings when I'm back from work and he was around a place by 7 p.m., then something was wrong. That's how we continue for. Greatly missed me and members of my family. We pray that his soul is in the bosom of the Lord. We thank you for the time we had with him.
Take the last testifier to be from the
baby.
The last testifier.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I am Rear Admiral B.J. Pascal. I was not opportuned to serve directly with Commodore Nkwesa, but I joined the service and was way ahead of me, and I used to see him from a distance. The air around him was always a reassuring one, very fatherly, and someone you can run to for help or for guidance in whatever situation you find yourself. He was very accommodating from a distance. We, the junior ones, we always look up to him. Be that as it may, my contact with his family, particularly Mr. Ike Nkwesa, just these last few days, really reaffirmed who the father was. Because he came across as someone who is very open and forthright, and who the military life, though a civilian, that openness that the military life has been built into him. And I believe it was a reflection of his father. It's unfortunate the peers of Commodore, late Commodore Kwesa are not here that will speak directly about him. But I believe this will do for the little contact I have with him. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. My name is Lady Osasa. I am the social secretary of Oguruchi Arui, where our daddy lives. I'm speaking on behalf of the president of Oguruchi Arui. Unfortunately, he's not able to make it here. Commodore Mike Okwese was once our CSO. When he was a CSO, in fact, he made a remarkable mark. In fact, he practically chased away criminals from the estate. All the security men that were there when he was a CSO, to date, they still talk good about him. On the activities of the GIP, he participated very well. When we go to meetings, you know we have to sit down to form a quorum. If Commodore Okwese has not come, we are very, very sure that we form quorum, because definitely he will come. He was very active, he was very articulate. In fact, he loved, because in the GRUA, we are one family. He loved the GRUA. We really miss him. But like, as we used to say, we cannot question God. May his soul rest in perfect peace.
Amen. Thank you. So much has been said about Bibom. I want to ask us, what will men say about you when you leave? It's a matter of time. We shall all leave the stage. And people will like to see some things about us. Let's think on that, reflect on it, and allow it to affect our lives positively. We'll continue as we see the next hymn. And I'm a stranger here on page 10.
Has been given to it, and everyone here will know what death is. Dictionary says it is the end of life of a person or organism, or the permanent end of a vital process. That was the definition given to death by dictionary. That is, the permanent end of a vital process. No matter how important we are, no matter who we are, it means that the process will end one day, like that of Commander Okesa. Different people have said a lot of things about death. Some say death is inevitable. That is, it is a death that every one of us must pay. Every one of us, we are going to pay that debt. And let us hear what the Bible says about this debt we are talking about. I'm sorry, I titled this brief exhortation, Prepare for Your Own Debt. Prepare for your own debt. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 9 verse 17, it says, just as man is destined to die once, and after that, to face judgment. That is, every one of us, it has been appointed that we will die once, and after that, there's going to be judgment. In Job chapter 14, it describes life of every man as planned, and at the appropriate time, it is cut down and withered. Verse 14, verse 21 now says, if his sons come to honor, he doesn't know it. That is, anybody that is dead, whoever that is in the grave, whoever that is dead, even if the children, if his children are being honored, he doesn't know about it again, because the end of that life has come. That was what Job 14:21 says. He says, if his son comes to honor, he doesn't know it. If they are brought low, he doesn't see it. He doesn't know anything that is happening again. Psalm 146 verse 6 says, when their spirit depart, they return to the ground on that day. Their plans comes to nothing. That is, everybody that died, every plan, I want to become this, I want to become that, everything comes to an end. In fact, another translation of that Psalm 146 verse 4 says, every of their thought perish. That is, all their thought, I want to be this, I want to be that, everything will perish when death comes. So dear people of God, all these things are telling us about a particular thing, that even while we are here, when we still have the opportunity to breathe, we should consider that later end of our life and prepare for it. All these were put together to tell us that we should make amends now that we have the opportunity to do so. That when you are still alive, Lord, we told us everything about that. That is, it is the end of an era. It is the end, and it is something that will happen to all because it is inevitable. But not only that, you are telling us that even for us that still have this, no matter the number of sermons we preach now, Baba Mike Okwesa is gone. He's no more here. He cannot hear this sermon. But the sermon we are preaching this evening is for every one of us that are still alive, so that we can make an amend of our life and follow Christ. I pray the grace to do so, the Lord may give to us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We must not learn it when it is too late, as it was too late for the rich man in the Bible story of rich man and Lazarus. He had the opportunity to change, to make amend of his life when he was here, but he didn't prepare for death. He didn't prepare for tomorrow, and he caught him unaware, and he found himself in hell. I pray hell will not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Dear people of God, death is an inescapable phenomenon in life. It is a topic we need to discuss, but we cannot run away from it. Why? Because we are not sure, number one, we are not sure of where we are going after now. Many of us, we are not sure of where we are going after now. So that makes us to fear death. Then number two, is that we still want to enjoy life small. Many of us want to enjoy life small. So we don't want anybody to talk about death, where we are. But it is real. Every one of us will leave the stage when it is time. The hymn we sang before this sermon, it says, here and a stranger. And Baba Omorinu was jokingly telling us there that even we, the priest here, we are a stranger in this dockyard, except him, because this is my first time of coming here anyway. So I'm a stranger here. Hallelujah. And when it is time, I have to leave this place, because this place is not my home. This place is not my place. Every one of us here, it will only remain the military officers here that are living in the compound. Every one of us will go back to where we come from. And be it Ogudu, be it TMS, or wherever you come from, you will go back home. That is how our existence in this world are. When it is time, we will all live here. But how prepared are you for where you are going? How prepared are you for where you are going? The book of Ecclesiastes chapter 7 verse 1 says, a good name is better than precious ornament, and the day of death than the day of one's birth. But let me read it out in the Message version. It says, a good reputation is better than a fat bank account, yet death date tells more than your birth date. Hallelujah. When we are born into, when we are coming into this world, at our arrival, nobody knows anything about us. We are plain, innocent. But the moment we start our journey in the world, we begin to write our own script by ourselves. And by the time we are going, people will be giving the testimonies of what we did, of what we do when we are here. If this kind of service is to be organized because of you, what are we going to say about you? What will the testimonies of people be concerning you? So how are you going to prepare for that? Because we know that we are not here for life. We know that our being here now is temporal. It's temporal. We are strangers here. And we are leaving this place one day. So how do you prepare for that end of yours so that your memory can be in everlasting remembrance? Number one, we must embrace salvation. We must embrace salvation. That is the number one thing to do. That is the best gift you can give to your God when you are alive. Embrace the offer of salvation that Christ gave to us. We are still in the season of Easter, where Christ laid down his life for you and I in order to redeem us back to God. Because in Genesis chapter 3, when man sinned, God sent man away from the garden of Eden. But Jesus Christ came to redeem us back to God, and he offered us salvation through Christ. And only those who believe in Christ, they are the one that we enjoy even after now. They are the one that will see the glory of God the Father even after now. They are the one that will not partake in the second death. I pray in that second death, you will not partake in it in the name of Jesus Christ. So for you not to partake in it, you must embrace salvation that Christ is offering you. That says in John 3:16, that for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Verse 17 says, for God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. So he sent Jesus Christ here so that you and I can be saved through Christ. So he offered you salvation. How are you embracing that salvation? Are you saved? If your end come today, or if God called you back home today, that enough of what of your activities in the world, okay, come back to base. Are you sure that you are saved? I pray the Lord will give us such grace in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. John chapter 10 verse 10 says, thief cometh not but to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But I have come to give them life. To be righteous, to live according to the pattern of God, your life must be another.
We want to sincerely appreciate the presence of our Father, Papa Yika Omololu for being with us for the start of this program. That is my breakfast. Thank you very much. God will keep you alive and good health for us in the name of Jesus. We'd just like to remind us that the service tomorrow is by 11 a.m. And we can go to Church of Christ, Marina, Lagos. So please, let's make it a day with the Lord. 11 a.m. We start at dot of time. We're praying for the family, and we want you to be sure that God's presence will continue to be with you. Baba, the Lord brother that we call home, but the Lord has not left you. His presence will sustain you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you very much for coming. God bless you. Now I'd like to invite a member of the family for photo thanks.
I'd like to recognize the senior clergy. Thank you, sirs, for honoring our family today. Especially Commodore Dr. Yika Omololu. We appreciate your presence here. I'd like to recognize the Flag Officer Commanding Western Naval Command, Grand Admiral Basser. It's an honor, sir. I'd like to recognize the retired Grand Admirals who are here, the retired Commodores, all other retired personnel, and colleagues of DAD. I'd like to recognize the family, the Aquesa family. I'd like to recognize Mommy. Mommy has been married to Dad for 54 years. It's not easy, but we're here to support you and be your strength. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for honoring our family. All I can say is that may God continue to bless you. Thank you for the support, the love, the gifts, the words of encouragement. It means a lot to the family. There are some of Dad's friends who are here, and I know they're hurting. He has very close friends. I just want to say thank you to his close friends for just being amazing friends to Father. We lived in a military family, and as a result of that lifestyle, we have made friends along the way. So I'm not going to be here to preach. But what I'll say is that what I've been said today is very important. Our time will come. And so I ask that it's an opportunity for everyone who has not accepted Jesus as their Lord and personal Savior to do so. We also must forgive, because God sent His Son, His only Son, to earth and sacrificed His life for all of our sins. And so if God could do that for His only Son, I humbly ask that we learn to forgive each other, accept Jesus as our Lord and personal Savior, because that's the way we will make heaven. So, on behalf of the Aquesa family, I say thank you once again. We appreciate the friendship, the love, the support. And may God guide you home safely. We hope to see you tomorrow at church. And just a reminder that the interment at Ebony Vaults is for family members only. So thank you so much for your time. We appreciate you all. Thank you.
first part has been taught in page 26. And we'll take together, the Lord wants to be my shepherd and my master. He makes the man and the man to be my service. He is the man of my father's shepherd. He refreshes my soul. He guides me and love for my right path for his name's sake.
Thank you. there is still a lot more to be done. As we started this service, we invoke your presence amongst us, and we are glad to testify that we sense your presence. Praise be to your holy name. Thank you for your son, great mind. Ask Lord that we continue to rest in perfect peace and apply perpetual respect upon him. Amen. We are now about to go to our various homes. As we go, Father, please go with us. When your children left their various homes, they usually talk before coming here or straight from home, they left in peace. They gave the God in peace. Amen. No evil will befall any of them. Amen. Your goodness and mercy will follow each and every one of us. Grant Father, please, to come tomorrow to continue to be here when we arrive. In particular, in the name of Christ, to honor and to honor the Lord. Keep us beyond that span, O Lord. And may your name continue to bless forever. To lighten our darkness, to assist you, Lord. And by your great mercy, defend us from all the perils and dangers of the life. For the love of your only Son. Amen. So the Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord look upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord let his countenance shine upon you. Give you joy in your life. Peace on your way. And love all around you. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with you. All those who are here today, this night and forever. Amen. Amen.
Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? And who told the ocean you can only come this far?